Sometimes when you upload an image to the Wiki, you'll find it doesn't fit inside the circular sections on the front page. In this instance here, we have a large image and it's been cropped off at the edges. And on this version, we have a small image and it's been stretched up to fit the circle, making the image blurry. To fix this, you should usually use an image that has equal proportions. That means an image that's square. And typically, you'll want to use an image that's 200 by 200 pixels. You can use a larger image, but it will just be scaled down. And you can get away with a smaller image, but around 100 to 150 pixels, it starts to become blurry. So I recommend 200 by 200 pixels. Also, you should make sure to leave some space around the edges of the image, because this will allow it to fit better in the circle. So, if we want to use this large image, it obviously doesn't fit, we'll need to edit the image. I recommend using a program like Photoshop over something like Microsoft Paint, just because Photoshop allows you to use layers, which makes it easier to make changes without affecting the main image. If you don't have Photoshop, you can find lots of free alternatives that you can download online, but if you don't want to download one, there is a program called Pixlr, which I would recommend, which you can get from www.pixlr.com. You go to the website, click on Open Image Editor, and after a moment or two, the Pixlr image editor will open, and it looks just like any other image editing software, just like Photoshop. It has things like layers, and up here, filters and things. So we want to open the image which we've saved on our computer. So this is the original image. And the first thing you want to do is check the size of it. Pixlr shows you the size here, or you can also go to image size. So this is 400 by 300 pixels. So we want to bring that down to a square 200 by 200 pixels. So we can resize the image here just by typing 200 in the width. Make sure you have constrained proportions on, that'll keep the dimensions square. But you'll notice the height is still not large enough. So we'll need to change that. If we change the height with constrained proportions off, then the image becomes distorted. So instead, we need to resize the canvas. Now, there's two ways to do this. The easiest way is to select, these are anchors, select the middle anchor here, and just type 200 pixels for the height. And that will apply these changes to the whole image. And because we haven't changed the width, that won't change, but we've changed the height, so the height will change. If you don't have the option of doing that, I mean, there's no reason why you shouldn't, you could instead, one after the other, apply half of what we're adding, so apply 25 pixels to each, so that would be 175 on the top, OK that, and then do the same for the bottom, and OK that. But say in this case, it's easier just to type 200 and apply it to the whole image. So that's basically made our image larger. The content is still in the middle, and luckily for us, in this image, it's got a white background, so we don't need to make any further changes. If you were using something like a photograph, you might find that the colour of your image doesn't match the colour of the canvas. The canvas typically would be white, so you'd need to use maybe tools like the clone tool, which you can find here. It's very similar in Photoshop, and that allows you to copy parts of the image and paste them elsewhere. Maybe try using a gradient or the paint bucket tool to fill in the area. Generally just to try and fill up the space so it looks neat in the circle. So we can now save this image. Save it under a different name. You can play with the quality settings. I'm going for full settings at the moment. The thing about JPEG to remember is that it's a lossy format. What that means is every time you save it, it loses quality. The image will become more and more blurry every time you save it. So it's best to start with as large an image as possible and save as least as possible as you can. and save that. And then if we go back to our wiki, I'm changing the middle image, so I have to go into setup and choose that picture. And there we can see, it's been applied to the middle, fits right in the middle. And you can use the same approach for all these other images, so ones like this are fine, but you'll notice over here there's a white border because the image is obviously taller than it is wide. So again, same again. In an image like this I'd probably use the clone tool to try and copy parts of this man's shirt to fill up the space. And that's all there is to it.